Hello guys, this is Pawan from Programmer's Pack, and in today's video we will see how to find sum of digits of a given number in C. So open Dev C++. Now press Ctrl+N for new file and start with the line hash include stdio.h. So this line includes the standard input output library in our program so that we can use some of the inbuilt functions. So now I'm writing the main function. In the main function, I'll be starting with declaring some integer data type variables like n, i, sum, and I'm initializing the value of sum as 0. So the value of sum I have given here 0. Now we have to take input from the user and store this value in the variable n. So I'm using scanf function. So in scanf function I'm writing %d because our data type is an integer, so that's why I'm writing %d. If the data type is float, then we have to write %f in that way. So here I'm writing %n. That means whatever value user input, it will be stored in the variable n. Now in order to find sum of digits of a number, we have to use a while loop. In the while loop, we will give the condition as n greater than equal to 1. That means as long as the value of n will be greater than 1, this while loop will be executed. The moment the value of n goes below 1, this loop will be terminated. So now in the while loop we have to write sum equal to sum plus n %10. Okay, and after that n equal to n divided by 10. So what I am doing here is, initially the value of sum is 0. Now I am adding the n modulo 10 with the sum. That means when n is divided by 10, whatever the remainder will be left will be stored, will be added to this sum. Suppose I am taking, for example, 36 is input, is the number given by the user. So since 36 is greater than 1, in this line 36 will be divided by 10 and 6 will be the remainder. So this n modulo 10 will return 6, and this 6 will be added to the sum which was initially 0, and now the sum will become 6. Now since from 36 we have added 6, we want to add 3 and we don't want our 6 anymore, so that's why I am dividing 36 by 10. So the new value of n will become 3. So when 3 will come over here, since 3 is greater than 1, the loop will be executed. And when 3 modulo 10 will give us 3, and we know that value of sum was 6, and 3 will be added to it, and the sum will become 9. Again, 3 will be divided by 10 and it will become 0.3. But since 0.3 is less than 1, this loop will not be executed. So we can see that 36 has been, both 6 and 3 have been added and the sum has become 9. Now all we have to do is print this sum. So I'm writing printf sum of digits equal to %d/n, and I'm writing here sum. Okay, so now all we have to do is compile this program, and before compiling it we have to save it. So write sum of digits .c. .c extension is very important. File name you can give as you want, but you have to use the .c extension because it's a C program. Now save it. And we can see over here, it's compiling now. And here it is. It shows 0 error, 0 warning. That means our program is error free. Okay, so now run the program. So, first example, I'm taking 36. Okay, so we know that the sum will be 9, and you can see here sum of digits is equal to 9. So the program is working correctly. Now check for some other numbers like 1, 2 and 3. We know the sum will be 6, and you can see here sum of digits is equal to 6. Again, take an example 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and you can see here sum of digits is 50. Now there is one problem, not problem I think, you can see here. I am writing 10 times 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is a very big number, and we know that 10 times 9 is equal to 90. So let's check our program can give the sum as 90 or not. So we can see here it's only giving 28. So I think there is some problem. Okay, the problem all over here is with the data type. Since integer data type has a very short range, that means it has a range of around 32,000 something. So for increasing the range, we can change the data type from int to long long int. And instead of %d, we have to write %LLD. Okay, so change it here and again here. Write %LLD. So we have seen here, instead of int, we are using long long int, and correspondingly, instead of d, we have to use LLD, that means long long, and for integer, we have d. So now compile it. Okay, so now check for 10 times 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So we know that sum will be equal to 90, and you can see here sum of digits is equal to 90. Which was previously 28, that was wrong, but this time it's correct. So whenever you got a problem with some big numbers, you can use this long long int data type. Its range is from minus 10 to the power of 9 to positive 10 to the power of 9. Okay, so I think you like the video. If you like the video, please hit the like button and subscribe button, and I will back with more good problems. Goodbye till then. Thanks a lot.